seen kinematics chapter in your textbook? There is no chapter named kinematics. Those who are saying that they have seen it, I don't know what they have saw. So there is no chapter of kinematics in your NCERT textbook. Okay? Kinematics is divided into two chapters in your NCERT book: motion in one dimension and motion in two dimension. Okay? So let us talk about kinematics a bit. Okay? Write down kinematics. What it is? What is kinematics? Physics is study of nature's law. What is kinematics? Study of motion. Study of motion is kinematics? Yes or no? Is it kinematics? Study of motion. Then what is law of motion? So when you have laws of motion, is that not the study of motion also?
Yes, but it's a part.
Entire mechanics is study of motion. Getting it? Entire mechanics is that. But what is kinematics out of it? What is kinematics? Kinematics is the study of motion without getting into cause of the motion. What is causing the motion? Getting it? I don't care what is causing the motion. Understood? It will be directly given to me that acceleration is this much, velocity is this much, how far the object will go after some time. So you can't ask from where acceleration has come, what is causing acceleration. Getting it? It will be directly given. We are not getting the cause of the motion. Cause of the motion we will get into chapters like laws of motion and work by energy. In laws of motion we will get to know that there must be force to create acceleration. And then you calculate the acceleration. Here acceleration most of the time will be given to you, or motion variables will be given to you. And you need to analyze. What do you have to analyze? Analyze the motion. It's not simple. Oh, what do you have to analyze? You have to analyze what is going to happen later on. In the future, what is going to happen? That is what you have to analyze in this chapter. Right now something is happening with the object. Okay, object has certain velocity, certain position and certain acceleration. You are trying to evaluate what is going to happen in the future. Getting it? So if you know the laws of kinematics, you will be able to control the motion of the object. Depending on present scenario, you can find out what is going to happen next. That is why we are studying kinematics. Okay, one very common example I can give you, not very very common, but then you know there are these devices that are made now which can automatically sweep your entire floor.
Yes.
You have it? Who is a super rich guy here? Okay. Get it, man. Get a couple of them. Distribute it. So you have... Nowadays, there are automatic sweeping machines that are there. It's a disc sort of thing which just moves in a room and cleans it. She has it. Or whether you know it. Okay. Fine. So, it's not very costly. Just a couple of $1,000.
Pocket change,
not money. Alright, so what I was talking about, suppose you have to create one sweeping machine yourself. You are like a great sweeper who you want to come up with an automated sweeping machine. So have you seen those toys which will go and hit something and then rotate a little bit, then again hits an obstacle, again rotates and keep on moving till it again hits something. Okay, so that's like simplest possible algorithm that you can make. That okay, if you hit, rotate by 30 degrees, move. You got hit, okay, again rotate. So like that, you will never get to know when you are going to get hit. Alright, and after hitting, rotating only, you rotate randomly in some direction. So if you have that kind of sweeping machine, it will take a lot of time to sweep. You might be sweeping one area only till infinity. You can hit from there, you go there. Then hit from there, again go there. You keep on sweeping this area. That is not what you want. Exactly. So it should be an intelligent sensor. So it should be most efficient sweeping machine will be such that if I have already swept here, that machine if I have swept here, that machine should not come here again. Okay? So machine should track where the machine has already before. Are you getting it? So machine will throw an hypersonic wave here and it will come back to the machine. So depending on how much time it takes for hypersonic wave to come back, the machine will get to know how far it is from the obstacle. So before hitting itself, it can take a turn. Getting it? So like that, if you know your kinematics, you can design this instrument without getting into what is causing the motion. Ultimately, what is causing the motion? What it is? Some motor inside the machine? What motor does? Just continuously rotate? After that, it is all kinematics. Motor creates a torque. After that, it is all kinematics. How you want to make sure it moves in such a way that it will take, let's say, 2 seconds to move there. It should not move with the speed of bullet, otherwise it will hit somebody and you will get hurt. Okay? So all that you have to design? Yes or no? So there are, entire robotics is based on kinematics. Suppose you have to design a robotic arm. Okay, so if you fold your arm like this, these fingers should automatically get folded. Okay, so depending on this motion, how much will be the motion of this finger, that finger, so all that is related. Okay, ultimately what is causing the hand to rotate is motor only. So I'm not getting into the cause of the rotation. I just want to know what will happen to the movement of a particular finger if I rotate my hand like that. Okay, so that is also kinematics only. Alright, so kinematics should be the most basic chapter of the physics. Okay, units and measurement, you can say that is essential part of the physics because you should know how to measure something. Okay, but that is not the, let us say, physics as such. Okay, it should be like a prerequisite kind of thing. After that, physics starts. So, kinematics you can treat as if it is a beginning of your physics. Alright, so we are going to learn about study the motion of an object. Alright, and what is the simplest kind of motion that is there? Motion in a straight line is the easiest kind of motion. Okay, so that is what we are going to learn in the first chapter. Motion in a straight line. Getting it? What is the next? What is the next kind of motion? After circular, after the straight line motion, then it is? 2D motion. It's a 2D motion. Okay? Suppose you have this, let us say, this is your y-axis, x-axis. Is this a 1D motion? Going like this. What about this? Is this a 1D motion?
No, but then it's moving in a straight line. So
then, so is it 1D?
Yeah. It is
1D. It is 1D. It's also 1D. This coordinate axis is your choice. God hasn't given you, listen, this is a coordinate axis and then see whether it's straight line or not. It is you have created. You could have created coordinate axis like this. Who was stopping you to make coordinate axis like that? Then you will say, okay, fine, this is 1D. Understood? Okay, so that is why at times, definition of motion in straight line, people casually say it is motion in 1D and then they think that if it is 1D, it should be only along a particular axis. That's not true. Okay, motion in 1D is motion in a straight line. Okay, fine. Now motion in 2D, you can say it is a motion which can be random. But it should be contained in a single plane. This motion, is it motion in a straight line? But is it in entire one plane?
Yes.
So this is motion in 2D. motion in two dimension. But right now our focus is motion in one day. So let me just quickly introduce to you how the chapter is arranged. Okay. Write down motion in one day. Studying the motion. See, you might have studied in till class 10th also, but I am assuming that you have not studied anything. Okay. So motion in 1D, when I say I am going to study the motion, I am going to study the motion from scratch. Okay. I am going to assume that you have never in your life studied the motion. Okay. So if I assume that, first I have to talk about the variables which I will be using to explain the motion. It's like, suppose I have to study length. So I should introduce meter and units. Similarly, if I have to study the motion, then I have to introduce few variables which I will be using to explain the motion. For example, displacement, time, velocity, acceleration. Okay, all those things we need to talk about. Okay, so here we have been talking about definition of the variables. Definition of the variables. Okay. This chapter was there in your class 9th. First chapter. Chapter name was motion. Okay guys, focus here. Then we are going to study the motion with constant velocity. Acceleration is zero. We are going to just study that. Okay, when I say constant velocity, even the object at rest is taken care of. It has a constant velocity of zero. Okay. Then I'm going to talk about constant accelerated motion. And everything is happening in a straight line. Everything is happening in a straight line, and this topic can be the most difficult topic. The numericals can go up to lots and lots of difficulty level. Okay, fine. So focus on the basics. If your basics are intact, you can, you know, at least hope to crack them. So this is constant accelerated motion. That is what we are going to study. Now when you hear about constant accelerated motion, what comes in your mind? Kya the jawab hai? Tell the answer.
Huh?
Are V is equal to U plus AT is not coming? No. So you have three equations of motion. Three equations of motion are there that are valid only when acceleration is constant. Getting it? So we are going to use those three equations of motion to analyze the motions. Alright, we are going to derive them also. We are going to study them from scratch. Alright, any doubts? No. So all of this is a part of your motion in 1D. Now, this is just introduction. Then we need to go beyond. So there is graphical analysis for everything. in one straight line. All the vectors. Displacement, velocity, acceleration, all of them in the one straight line. But you should not forget the fact that you are dealing with vectors. So in a straight line also, one direction could be positive, the other one will become negative. Understood? Alright, so this is how the entire chapter is arranged. Alright, today I hope to complete this part and get the middle of this one. Motion in 2D, we are going to elaborate it when we study. Okay. Any doubts, anything you want to ask related to this? Now there can be questions. Okay. Don't argue. Focus here. Focus. So what I was saying was that in this chapter, the cause of the motion is not something which we are studying. Okay? But it doesn't mean that there will not be a numerical in which cause of the motion is not there. There can be a numerical from laws of motion chapter in which you have to first find the acceleration and then use the kinematics fundamentals. Getting it? Okay? So there will be a mixed numerical also. So what you have to do? First finish this chapter, then finish law of motion chapter, and then again come back to this chapter. And units and measurement chapter also. Okay? All the chapters are intertwined. Okay? But then if your focus is just school level, then you can afford to study in isolated manner. But then you cannot afford to study in an isolated manner if you are focusing on any of the competitive exams. Okay?